Hi, welcome to another Make It Monday. I'm Jennifer Ellefson and I'm going to show you a layered aperture technique today with a glitter window. We're going to start off by making this card today, and the way we're going to start is with a panel of hibiscus burst, 3¾ by 5, and the mat stack 4 die. I find that this technique is much easier if you start from the largest die and work to the smallest, so that's how I'll show you today. We're going to use the negative portion of this cut and set aside the positive for later. I'm going to use a little repositionable adhesive on the back of this. And then I'm going to layer it onto a panel of Enchanted Evening, and that's 4 by 5¼ inch. Now I'm going to take the limitless layer C, which is the scallop die, and send that through. Just position it where you want it. And you can see your window starting to form. Now I'm going to take an A2 card base from Stamper Select White, and again a little repositionable adhesive, just get that centered. Now I'm going to take Limitless Layer A, the circle, open up the card, and place the die right in the center. And there's your window. So what that's going to enable us to do is to pull out some stamps and stamp right through the center. I'm going to use this image from 2011 birthday tags. I'm using Enchanted Evening ink. Now I'm going to use the small cupcake image from the same set in a hibiscus burst ink. That's fun because now you can show your image right through the center. Now I'm not quite done, so I'm going to use a mask that I used from some printer paper. And I'm going to ink up the polka dot mat stack 4 image with fresh snow ink. I'm just going to stamp that right through. The mask is just there in case I get off center at all. And since it's repositionable, you can just take it right off. And the sentiment is the Happy Birthday sentiment from Simple Sentiments. I'm just going to use the Enchanted Evening ink again and right along the bottom. Now, since we used repositionable adhesive on this, we can take it off, but once you put it through the die cut machine, the pressure makes the adhesive even that much stronger. So I'm going to peel off these top two layers, but you'll see experiencing a little trouble, a little bit of marring, but since we're going to re-adhere it, it's really not a problem. So I'm going to put some permanent adhesive on the back of this panel. And for my ribbon accent, I'm using Enchanted Evening Bitty Dots. I've already tied a square knot in a length of it, and I'm going to just snip the back, center it around this panel, and adhere it to the permanent adhesive that I've just put on. and that lets the back of your ribbon pieces be hidden as well. So just re-adhere the panel, and you see you have a great aperture card. Now I'm going to show you how you can take this a step further. So open it up and grab some packing tape, just normal scotch or whatever packing tape you have on hand. Cut a length that'll cover the aperture and make it so that the non-sticky side is inside your card. So this is your sticky side outside. Grab a little bit of glitter and just sprinkle it right over that sticky part. And just like you would with embossing powder, just tap it around and then dump off the excess. I'm just going to grab my embossing buddy here and get the couple strays that are here. And here's what you have. The glitter window technique is really fun, and I'm really glad that you were able to join me on this Make It Monday. Love to see your take on the aperture and the glitter window, and place it on Nicole's blog.